Dear students, until now we have discussed different types of instructions, whether they are data transfer instruction, ALU instruction, or control unit group instructions. In today's module, we will be mainly focusing how using those set of instructions, a program is executing actually within the computer. So for machine instructions, they are following from main memory to CPU. So you know that all of our program is available or residing in the main memory, and that is being fetched from main memory to the computer, to the CPU more specifically. And then each instruction is decoded. What is being asked by the instruction to be performed by the CPU, and then the actual execution take place. For supporting such a program execution, there are two special purpose registers available in CPU. So you might remember when we discussed about the registers, we only talked about general purpose registers which hold the data of different things. However, these two important registers, known as instruction register and program counter register, mainly focusing and giving us a hand to execute the program properly. So the instruction register holds the instruction being executed at the moment, and the program counter saves the address of the next instruction that is being fetched from the main memory. So if you see this diagram, which we have already seen previously, we have a central processing unit here and the main memory, and we have bus for data transfer. So here are two special purpose register, program counter and instruction register. In this main memory, in different cells, the instructions are placed. So for example, at address 0, there is an instruction in binary. At address 01, there is another instruction in binary, and so on. So what would be the flow? That in the start, in program counter, the address would be first location where the instruction is to be fetched, is saved. And the instruction register will hold this instruction, the content of the cell at address 00. And as soon as the instruction is fetched and placed within the instruction register, the program counter is incremented by 1 or by 2. So it will be incremented by 1 when the next instruction is available in the next location. However, if our instruction is comprised of 2 bytes, then this addition would be of 2 bytes. And similarly, such a program will be executing, fetching the instructions, and program counter will be pointing to the next instruction and executing that instruction within the central processing unit. So this would be the machine cycle. So first of all, we will perform fetch, as I have already explained, that it retrieves the next instruction from memory as indicated by the program counter, and then increment the program counter. After that, there is a decode phase. So in decoding phase, we try to understand what has been said by the instruction. So for example, if there is an instruction 10XY, so this instruction might be telling us that this is a load instruction and you need to load data from the memory location XY to the register 0 within the CPU. And after decoding, that instruction is handed over to the execution phase that actually performs the action within the CPU. So if we summarize today's module, we have learned that how a program is executed, and we have learned the purpose of two special registers known as instruction register and program counter, and we have discussed three phases of an instruction from fetching, decoding, up till the execution of the instruction.